In the last video, we showed you our awesome trip to Tan Lap Floating Village with lots of fun things to see and peacefully wonderful things to do in this rural area. After the activities there, we returned to our hostel and took a little nap to recharge ourselves for the next road trip, which is supposed to happen in a couple hours.
Madi was so tired, she passed out for 1.5 hours.
That's only for Madi, cause I couldn't fall asleep at all. But that's okay, as the next province we're about to visit is expected to have its own unique things to offer, which we'll show you all in this video. The next province is called Tien Giang, which is only 70 kilometers from Ho Chi Minh City and 41 kilometers from a hostel in Long An. One thing that is very special about Tien Giang is that when here, you can't really tell that it used to be a deserted area that was home to so many dangerous animals because its land now has been turned into plenty of vast rice fields and abundant orchards, all thanks to its location along the north bank of Tien River. And this is why the province is named after the river Tien Giang. Tien means front and Giang means river in Vietnamese. And later in our southwest trip, we'll also show you the back river as well.
With an area of more than 2,300 square kilometers, this rich land of Vietnam has about 1.7 million citizens. Having about 120 kilometers of land along the river, it's naturally gifted with an everlasting amount of alluvium that is key to making up the current wealthy look of the entire place here. Over the years, with the blooming business of tourism, especially ecotourism, many get to see why this province is given the name the Kingdom of Fruits. Accounting for 8% of the fruit cultivation area, Tien Giang is the largest one in the whole country, producing a high yield of high-quality fruit. Some fruits here even have their own reputation names for domestic and international markets. I'm very much tempted to tell you a few, but they're all in Vietnamese, hence hard to remember. Just make sure you try their mangoes, dragon fruits, durians, and pomelos when you're here.
In this video, we're gonna make it to the best district for food named Cai Bè, which will take us around 1 hour. It's now around 3 p.m.
So we're gonna make it to another hotel, which is located in a different province, Tien Giang.
It's still very hot, so...
Hey David, do you feel like you need another cup of coffee?
No, I don't feel like coffee right now, but I do feel like, honestly, sugar cane juice. Oh, we just passed it.
There'll be another one coming up, most likely.
I'm gonna get a Red Bull while you're gonna get a tea drink.
All right.
Okay.
As we're closing in on our final destination, the roads get smaller, yet somewhat busier, so I gotta slow down cause someone might suddenly appear in the middle of the road. It's better to be safe than sorry.
Look at this, the bridge is just as high as all of the houses on the side. This is crazy.
Our thought is, how can people live down there with the constant dirt and water released from commuting vehicles on the bridge? Interesting.
After 1 hour and 15 minutes on the road, we're now on the nicest road on which our next hotel is located. We found this hotel by simply choosing Cai Bè as our final spot, and when we got very close, we used Google to search hotels near me. Works every time.
How did you like this trip so far?
It's pretty good. The traffic and the cars getting cut off.
All of the roads were just really narrow and winding.
But that's fine and dandy.
I think this road trip was pretty nice. Let's go find a room. Same table. Wow. All right, this one looks like a resort. And look at that. So C14 is our room.
C14?
C14. Man, this is beautiful. Look at this.
Okay, how much is this gonna be though?
We quickly glimpsed through all its photos on Google, and what we're drawn to is its garden and how clean as well as accessible our room is.
Everything is so organized, lush, and also clean. Walking in here just makes me believe that I'm walking into a resort. Oh, this one?
Oh,
there's a lizard. You get a little desk too to work today.
What are you doing?
Oh, there's just a little bug trying to see if it's a bed bug or something.
I think with this bed and everything, like the fitted sheet and everything, we don't have to use
the tarp
anymore, because like in the last hotel that we stayed, The bed inside was like really nasty. And Madi didn't like the fitted sheet, didn't like all of the pillows.
No, what deterred me was, is right as soon as we got there, right? We hadn't even touched anything, and I went to go lay down and I looked at the pillow I was about to lay on and I saw dandruff. And that's what freaked me out. And so I was like, they didn't change anything. And then when we left and like checked out technically and came back,
yeah,
the pillow was just brushed off, but there were still specks of dandruff. Nothing changed. Pretty much the things that were changed was the towels, another toothbrush, and finally took out the trash. Okay, we're running out to get something to eat for dinner. Man, it is late already. It is like 10 o'clock.
10 o'clock, and somebody just took a long nap while I was working the entire time.
I took my second nap for 2 hours. It was a good nap, I have to admit. But then somebody scared the crap out of me to wake me up. Yeah, you did. Scared me really bad. I think that's payback for me sleeping for 2 hours and him not getting any at all.
That restaurant is just right there.
Yeah, right across the street. We could walk.
Yeah. It looks like a good one. Let's go, let's go. So we chose a gravel part of the restaurant, which has all of the lights hovering above of us. Look at this, how romantic this is. For many of you who don't know, we try to be pescatarians for 3 months before. We still try even though it's hard when being on trips like this. Lucky us, tonight, at this restaurant, they even have an aquarium for us to choose desired seafood from. Do you know what this is? In Vietnamese, we call it ốc voi voi, an elephant trunk clam. In English, it's gooey duck, a species of very large saltwater clam. It looks very interesting, but I think I should just go for what Maddie's always been in love with. So I picked this.
What did you get?
What did I get?
Yeah.
So I chose a crab, a live crab with the highest quality. And it's like the most expensive. It has like a lot of meat, and it also has like something that we called egg. So like an egg sac inside of the crab. That's why it makes the quality of the crab so much better.
Okay.
And it's more expensive that way.
Right.
Wow, this is so fast.
So for our dinner, under this romantic light, we have fried crab nicely soaked in tamarind sauce and a plate of mango salad with shredded freshwater dried fish.
I'll give you the best part first.
They're all so delicious, and we don't even realize how fast we emptied them. This is a much needed recharging meal for us to kickstart our next day.
Good morning, guys. It is day 3 of our trip through the southern provinces of Vietnam. We just woke up and it is already 7 a.m. So this hotel that we're staying at is absolutely stunning.
Look at all this.
The best time to have your breakfast is within 2 hours of waking up. So our next day starts with an early trip to a coffee shop. Don't know where it is yet, as we still gotta find it by riding around. But it's not a problem, because we do find the place very pleasing with pretty good morning vibes to go around.
Finally arrived in a cafe nearby, and it's time for some morning coffee. Our favorite one is Cafe Shu Da, Vietnamese iced coffee with condensed milk. It's actually a lot longer to say in English, so many people just call it Cafe Shu Da for short.
I got bit by a lot of mosquitoes last night. I regret not putting on the mosquito repellent.
No.
So how are you feeling right now?
I feel very tired, got up so many times last night.
I slept, on the other hand, like a rock, though.
I know how you sleep.
Oh, yeah. Also, I remember asking you last night what you wanted to do when you wanted to take the boat through the canal.
Right now, I don't have anything in mind. Honestly, we are going on these trips on a budget. We don't have a lot of money, and we just want to kind of cultivate the idea and the feeling of being in close attachments with the nature. And going on a random trip like this, unplanned, with everything ahead of us, is one of the ways that you can actually have that, right? So if you go to some of the tourist attractions or you can book some tours, of course, they're gonna be amazing, but it's not going to be a lot better compared to ours, because I think I'm gonna do my job of speaking, talking to friendly locals around here to see if there's something that we can do or there's some places that we can go in order to have like the best experience in these locations.
But that's also like the beauty of it. You get to see so many different things as opposed to like where the tourist agencies, they'll take you to hit up certain spots, and then those spots have developed so much over time to really attract more tourists, right? And so it's not as authentic anymore.
The hotel owner was the one who suggested us going to the canal and go along the canal to experience all of the orchards.
Well, then that would be perfect.
And that's everything that we can tell you for now about the orchard trip. Let's go find something to eat.
Waiting for the lady to make our bánh mì.
That's what I always want. Every single time, I always ask for the same thing.
No matter where we go or what time it is, whether it's breakfast, lunch, or dinner, I can always eat a Vietnamese sub. It is that good. I think if we ever leave Vietnam, this is something that I am going to miss having. But unfortunately, with me always craving a sub, that means David is probably already sick and tired of eating this.
Are you sick of it?
Yeah, pretty much.
Which makes me feel guilty sometimes, but at the same time, I don't feel guilty.
As I'm eating breakfast, Madi comes and helps put the mosquito cream on me. How sweet of her and spoiled of me. As you may ask, why put on the cream, right? We honestly don't know. There's a lot of water around and we're not sure if the scalding heat from the sun will scare the mosquitoes away, so we need more insurance this way.
It's around 12 o'clock, which is really, really sunny and hot. So we gotta gear up all the way.
Good to go.
Let's go get some fruit.
Are we gonna get durian?
I don't know yet.
Okay.
Maybe.
This might seem odd to a lot of North Americans of like covering up everything, no matter how hot it is, but trust me, if you want to protect your skin from one, aging, and two, possible skin cancers, then this is absolutely necessary. For today's adventure on the scooter, we don't need the cargo or the tent, just us and our backpacks. All right, let's go.
Yup, riding to the pier, then catching a boat to get to the orchard around noontime. We're testing our luck here as many places are temporarily closed for lunchtime. It's not easy for us to navigate to the pier either, as Google Maps doesn't know the real route that people get to the orchard. It makes sense because there's no way it knows that we have to take a boat, right? Anyway, we ended up having to ask some people on the road to get to the pier's ticket center. But here, we're facing with what we're afraid of. They're temporarily off for lunch.
The ticket lady is gone. She's probably home right now to eat lunch. And so maybe we have to wait for her until she gets back and gives us some tickets.
All right, so with the ticket lady being gone, that means we can go find lunch ourselves and maybe get you another cup of coffee. I think if we walk down that way, it'd be pretty interesting.
Okay.
Foot. So change of plans. We decided not to get anything to eat because since we're going to be visiting the orchard, we might be eating more fruit. So we don't want to fill our stomachs up with food or a lot of food before we go and eat more food.
Sounds like a very logical plan, but we'll see about that.
What does this look like to you? It's actually called a flan cake, made of rich custard with a nutty caramel syrup. Since it's pretty sweet and rich, people usually drizzle in some coffee to provide that perfect bittersweet custardy flavor. Highly recommended as it's
ooh,
That's really good.
And then I found out that the shop owner has this little green iguana here. Never seen one in person before, but it looks pretty chill and cool. I think I watched a video that talks about this kind of reptile being hunted for food. That's not the case here. They're pretty expensive and adored by quite a few people as they're not aggressive towards humans unless they're stressed out. People even call them African green dragons. Anyway, I'm not touching it just to be safe.
I'm feeling good.
All right, it's now time to get back to the ticket station and hopefully the lady's back on her job.
There are a few people that made it here before us, and since they want to go do and see the same things, we're grouping as a pack of six to have a much better price for the tickets. Ideally, their long boat can fit up to 10 people with the best deal of around 150,000 for each ticket. But we're fewer than 10, so we need to pay 250,000 per visitor.
Where are you from?
I'm from America.
Because it's hot out,
I got a hat. David has a hat.
We get special hats.
It's a palm leaf conical hat, aka the famous Vietnamese non la, a traditional symbol of Vietnamese people that has a history of over 3,000 years, all thanks to its easy to find material and shielding functions to protect the head.
Man, they were pretty nice too. Well, the lady started talking to me. I liked her.
That one is going to be the boat that we're going to be on later. There you
Thank
go.
Thank you.
My turn.
Okay. Everyone else got on with ease, and I'm like shaking as I go down.
Oh, in case you ask why the water is so murky and muddy, its orange look is primarily made of all the loose clay, silt, sand, and gravel that drifted to lower parts of the river from higher areas. They're called alluvium, and this special type of soil is deemed to be highly fertile for crops. And a moment ago, we were just strangers, but now everyone seems to get along very well. She just asked me to turn my face around for a photo, and in return, I give her some well-intentioned fingers to make her photo even better. A little bit about the Mekong, the 12th longest river in the world. Its course starts in the Tibetan Plateau and ends in the southwest region of Vietnam, connecting six countries including China, Myanmar, Laos, Thailand, Cambodia, and Vietnam. The river has a few different names for these nations' locals to refer to the part of the long river in their countries. In Vietnam, it's called Cửu Long River, or the Nine Dragon River, because it has nine different branches or exits before reaching the East Sea of Vietnam. But before hitting those nine branches, the river only has two large ones, as I told you at the beginning of this video, Tien River or Front River and Ho River or Bat River. We are now on Tien River. It's huge, isn't it?
Some of the activities you often see here are orchard viewing tourism, waterborne transporting, and fishing. And the green plant you see on the water over there is called water orchid. There's lots of it here. Finally made it to the first stop. There are multiple places like this along the bank that offer goods like coconut taffies, pop rice products, honey tea, and royal jelly. Each one has its own special tastes or health benefits. But first, let's try some samples.
How is it?
It's really good.
The biggest boy is still hot. This one is still hot. That's what it is. The flavor, the taste. This is something that I'm familiar with. I grew up eating a lot of this.
People often come here for one thing, and that is to see how some of these products are made freshly from scratch. You will also be invited to get your hands on things to experience and take some photos.
This wok is used to make some pop rice, and the process starts with heating the sand up. Instead of using wood or other types of fuels, they use shells of rice, lychees, and longans. My guess is they use these shells because they're small and easily dragged down into the firebox. After tossing in the wok a scoop of whole rice with shells on it, the rice is beginning to pop under the heat from the surrounding sand, just like how you make some popcorn. And stir the mixture of rice and sand very well to speed up this process. After all the rice grains popped, she used this tool to sift the sand right back into the wok and only keep the popped rice and the shells. To take the shells out, the mixture has to pass through two more sieves, one with lots of shaking and the other with lots of rubbing. Now the popped rice is all ready to be made into the final product. This is similar to popcorn because without some added flavor, the rice is pretty much tasteless. But while waiting to be made into some delicious pieces of flavored popped rice, the freshly made batch just sits in a plastic bag like this.
Sample. It's time to taste some samples.
Got the green one. That green one was tasty.
Royal jelly?
Yeah. Anti-aging. Yeah.
So many health benefits.
Insomnia.
This is when we learn about some health benefits of royal jelly, and it dropped in our tea a few balls of their samples.
You tied it wrong.
I know.
Okay. Goodbye. Oh, thanks.
How are you feeling?
After a while of being on the boat, I suddenly feel pretty sick. My head starts to spin and hurt, and I honestly couldn't wait to get off the boat at all. But when David asked,
"You're gonna be okay?"
"I'll be fine. Just..."
"You'll be fine?"
"Yeah."
To get to the orchard, we need to pass through a narrow and shallow canal, meaning we have to switch to a smaller rowing boat, which is part of this trip. Each of these boats can withstand up to 5 adults, including the rowing person. So Maddie and I got split from our fellows to be on a separate one.
Alright. Are you gonna be alright? Alright, give me the hat. You know, this is one of the functions
of the hat. That's not what I need right now. I just wanna chill. I think going slower is helping a little bit.
Yeah, I think I made some terrible mistake, guys. So apparently I always know that Madi is allergic to pollen, and then when we were sitting at the table drinking some honey tea, the staff there just offered us some pollen balls. I thought it was good for our stomach or something. It's healthy for a variety of people, but then apparently it's not for Madi because like she has pollen allergies, so...
Well, my allergies are never like that bad, right?
This is only our speculation for why I'm feeling sick.
But I have like a teaspoon of that stuff, like just dumped it right in the tea, mixed it all in, drank it. It was tasty.
But I feel so bad because I was the one who asked her to try it.
Sorry.
No, it's okay. We didn't know about it would be like that.
Okay.
All right, what are all the things sticking up out of the ground?
So you see like all of the spikes right there? Those are the roots from all of these big trees. Man, I've never seen any roots like that.
After having a chat with our rowing lady, we learned that people like her only make 15,000 or about 60 US cents to deliver a boat like this to the orchard, no matter the number of passengers. The problem is, it takes her 30 minutes to row, and if the tide is down, she even has to jump into the water to push the boat through. After COVID, everything became harder around here, so if she's lucky, she can make around 3 to 4 trips a day. What a tough job.
She told us that if she's not in a hurry, the part up here will be very shallow to row through. So she switched to using a motor with propellers now.
I like seeing all of the mudfish hopping around. Like, you just look over and you just see them like go doo 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 back into the hole, like that.
trying to describe what they look like, they look like a tadpole that's never fully grown. So the front of it looks like a frog, and then they got a tail in the back.
Along the banks, there's lots of mudfish and crabs, like this little one here.
Okay, so now we're close.
And we finally made it to the orchard. Remember that our plan was to have our stomachs empty for filling up on fruit later? Yeah, we're super giddy about it now. This place is only one of the orchards that have been cooperating with the ecotourism company to let people visit their yards. When coming here, you'll get to walk around their fruity land and pick what you want fresh from the trees. But you need to pay for it unless your tour guide gives it to you. Yeah, now we know our initial understanding that our tickets are inclusive of eating fruit as much as we want is not the case.
Well, you can still eat some fruit, but only on some small sample plates like this. They're not very tasty though. Right as soon as we got closer to the housing and shopping area of the orchard, we were led to this table to listen to some live performances and enjoy their fruit. This type of music and performance began in the early 20th century and blossomed in the 1930s. Like most types of long-standing traditional music in the world, it's not that catchy or even pleasant to listen to if you haven't heard it before or you don't know the meaning. But most Southern Vietnamese value this as associated with the nostalgia of the past. So it's very common to hear it anywhere around this part of the country.
Tips at a table like this are to look at them, to show your respect, and leave a few cents to help motivate them for the effort they put forth to maintain this traditional art. You'll be given fake flowers, so you can roll the bill in the flower and give it to the performers, like me here. Not much monetarily or compulsory traditionally. It's all about the respect on your part.
Look at that, how beautiful.
It's about the time we learn something not very nice.
Too bad for the panda, there's no durian that she can eat from the tree.
I totally would have paid for it.
They already harvested most of the good fruit for sale, so the orchard now only has a few common types left.
Do you like this?
No, I wasn't sure what to expect today, so I thought it was just a simple boat ride.
They're applying like so many strategies and tactics here in order to be able to have fruits, even though it's not in its own season.
Walking in here is nice. At least, we learn how they pollinate some fruit trees manually to make them give fruits even when they're not in the right season. Fruits that are made this way are often for special occasions like Lunar New Year and are quite expensive.
Exactly. Oh yeah. I think the reason that they wrapped everything up was because like they wanted the fruits to be protected from all of the insects or bees or whatnot. Okay, so all grown like organically. Without any fertilizers or pesticides. Right, just like that. Right. And she also said that it's not sour. Look at that. It's a little fuzzy on the outside. It's like crunchy and expectedly it's not sour. As opposed to a regular amberella. So
it's like a young mango.
Yeah, pretty much, right? I think that the texture is a little better than even mangoes. Oh yeah. Beautiful. It's a nice experience. Even though we don't have a lot of fruits here, but it's okay. Do you have stuff like this in Cambodia, Victor?
Yeah, basically Cambodia is just the lake, the
rivers. Oh yeah. Same, right? So nothing like unique and special to you here. How do you like this whole thing so far?
It's a really cool experience, and I can't wait to see what else there is to offer here.
Man, they're walking like real fast, so you gotta catch up, babe. Go, 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 go. You're right. I gotta take my hat off too. Okay, right over here, I think they have some display tables of souvenirs. This final product right here is made of this.
These are dried stems of water orchid plants that can go rampant in the waters within a short amount of time. If not collected, they can be a real pain for boats to take their routes. Quite amazing for the idea of turning something totally useless into such beautiful, environmentally friendly products like these, right?
For me, what sounds equally amazing now is to have a tamarind drink using the jam they're making here. Tamarind is known for its sourness, but when made into a jam, it's like it tastes so good and quite sweet. The secret ingredient that complements the whole drink is roasted peanuts.
Sorry, I already drank most of the tamarind drink because it's one of my favorites. She was making it there in front of us too, so she gave us a little skewer to try some of the jam that she was making, and oh my gosh, it is super sour, but I'm the type of person to love like super sour things.
Now I got my wish from yesterday. Enough for you.
And that is our trip to the second province of Southwest Vietnam, Tien Giang. In the next video, we're gonna be back on the road to head to Bánh, the province well known for everything coconut. Here, we get to do some other fun new things and be able to enjoy the beauty of the river from a different angle.
We also hope you enjoyed our adventure to the district of Cai Bay. If so, leave a like and subscribe to our channel to be notified when we release future videos. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you again.